Hello students, now in this video we will discuss about the causes of poverty and the last unit of the chapter, that is anti-poverty measures. First reason is low level of economic development under the British colonial administration. The Britishers has exploited our industries as well as our handicraft industry. The failure at both the fronts, promotion of the economic growth and the population control, perpetuated the cycle of poverty. At one side, we are talking about the economic growth and we are not able to control the rapid growing population. So it is never able to possible that our country, the country like India, can make any changes with the scenes related to the poverty. Without controlling the population, which is actually the root cause of all the problem. Because many of the industrial sectors and many of the primary sectors are not able to generate the job opportunities which is matched with the upgrowing population. Means, agar so नौकरी है तो वहां पे पॉपुलेशन आपकी 1 लाख है तो इट इज नॉट मैच्ड विद द पॉपुलेशन. द फर्स्ट थिंग इज दैट कि फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी वर टोटली फेल्ड टू जनरेट द जॉब अपॉर्चुनिटीज इन इंडस्ट्रियल सेक्टर, इन प्राइमरी सेक्टर एंड एज वेल एज इन द टर्शियरी सेक्टर. एंड एंड सेकेंड फ्रंट, पॉपुलेशन इज ऑल्सो रैपिडली इंक्रीजिंग डे बाई डे. Another reason, irregular small incomes. Then huge income inequalities. Here in our country, the Tata, Birla and Ambanis are there. And in the same country, they have the people, those who are not able to get a square meal a day. Many other socio-cultural reasons are also there. See, in India, sometimes, first of all, we are totally under the grip of these social and cultural rituals. We did not try to bring any change in the society. We are always against the changes. And whatever changes are brought here, which is, first of all, in the beginning, they were not accepted by the society, but later on, it was welcomed with wholehearted. Economic factor are also responsible for poverty. Now, anti-poverty measures. The government, see, we had already talked about these causes. To reduce the causes or to minimize these causes, certain steps have been taken by the government. And all these are coming in anti-poverty measures. The current anti-poverty strategy of the government is broadly based on 2 factors or planks. First one, the promotion of economic growth, as we had discussed earlier also. And second one is targeted anti-poverty programs. Targeted anti-poverty programs means within the limit time period, we are trying to complete the reduction of poverty from a particular region through these programs. What are those? We will discuss about these programs one by one. First one is Prime Minister Rojgar Yojana. This Yojana or scheme was launched by Prime Minister of India on 2nd October 1993. The main aim of this Pradhan Mantri Rojgar Yojana is to provide employment to the educated unemployed youth by setting up industries, services and business sectors. To provide financial assistance to any youth between the age of 18 to 35 years and belonging to families whose annual income is less than 24,000. These schemes are mentioned in your book. So any schemes are there for your examination, प्लीज ट्राई टू रिमेम्बर कि इन विच ईयर देवर लॉन्च्ड एंड व्हाट आर द मेन ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दीज स्कीम्स और प्रोग्राम्स. नेक्स्ट वन REGP means Rural Employment Generation Program, means this scheme will try to generate the employment in rural areas. It was launched in the year 1995 and its main objective is to create self-employment opportunities in rural areas as well as in small towns. It cover all Indian village industries set up in the rural areas to finance almost 90-95% of the project cost, especially in the rural area. A target of creating 25 lakh new jobs have been set for it under the 10th 5-year plan. Last point is important because most of the time it comes for 1 marks question. National Food for Work Program. National Food for Work Program NFWP. It was launched in the year 2004 and in 150 most backward districts of the country. And what is the main objective of this program? To augment food security through wage employment in drought prone areas. Drought means sukha pada hua ilaka. And to pay wages partly in kind or partly in cash. थोड़ा kind यानी कि चीज के रूप में, किसी वस्तु के रूप में और कुछ cash के रूप में. प्रधानमंत्री ग्रामोदय योजना. It was launched in the budget or introduced in the budget of 2000 and 2001 with an aim to improve the quality of living of the rural people. Its main objective is to provide all weather roads to the rural areas, to develop the housing in rural areas, to provide safe drinking water, then to provide water for harvesting, water harvesting and conservation, to provide health facilities and primary education. SGSY, Swarna Jayanti Gram Swarojagar Yojana. It was launched in the year 1999 with the aims to promote enterprises at the elementary village level, to assist families in bringing above the poverty line by organizing them into self-help group SHG through a mix of bank credit and government subsidy. Government suvidha deti hai. To take up income generating economic activities. And the last aim of this SGSY is to take up income generating economic activities. Antyodaya Anna Yojana. This scheme was launched in the year 2000 on 25th of December. Its main objective is to ensure food security to the poor, to identify poorest of the poor and provide them Antyodaya ration card, which is red in color. To provide 10 kg of rice and 25 kg of wheat at the rate of 3 rupees per kg and 2 rupees per kg. And this one is Manrega, Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Program. Narega was launched on 2nd Feb 2006 and renamed to Manrega, means Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Program, with effect on 2nd October 2009. Its main objective are to provide 100 days. Nowadays, the government is planning to increase from 100 to 150 days. Of guaranteed unskilled wages employment in a year to each rural household opting with 15 days application. To implement the same in all the backward districts of the country at the average of Rs. 132 per day in 2013 and 14. These are the government steps or the government poverty alleviating programs, which somewhere is able to reduce the poverty from the country. But still, we have so many challenges. Like, the greatest challenge for India is the rural-urban disparity, means differences, and the state-interstate disparity. Second, poverty reduction is expected to make better progress in the next 10 to 15 years due to higher economic growth, stress on free elementary education, declining population growth, increasing empowerment of the women, and upliftment of the economically weaker sections of the society. That's all. These are the points in the chapter. Once again, I am recalling all the points. First, what is poverty? Second, two stories or two cases which are related to the poverty in the form of Ram Charan and Lakha Singh. Then, what are the issues which are related to the poverty? Then, social indicators as seen by the different social scientists. Then, what is social exclusion? What is this vulnerability? Then, poverty line. Then, poverty estimate. Then, interstate disparity. Then, the global poverty scenario or world poverty. Then, the causes of poverty. And last one is anti-poverty measures or the steps taken by the government to reduce the poverty. Thank you.